It all depends. So when I look at the way that I scale out my businesses, what I want to do is I want to get the maximum bang for my buck and also the maximum bang for the effort invested into it. Okay, so for instance, Amazon, while it is ludicrously smart to set up your product to sell it on Amazon, because that's where the majority of the customers for e-commerce actually go, particularly in the Western world anyway, okay? So starting with Amazon makes perfect sense, but then where do you go after that? Where should you go next? And that's going to be dictated by what you sell, and more importantly, where your customers are. So for me, what my strategy tends to be is I go Amazon and then usually eBay, because I've got other customers who shop on eBay that don't shop on Amazon and vice versa. And then normally in America, I'll either go somewhere like Walmart or Jet. So you can sell as a seller, you can operate just like on Amazon on both of those two platforms. And again, I'm just wanting to put my product in front of people who we've got their purses out, they're ready to buy. That's what I'm looking to do, and I'm looking to get the most amount of those people for the minimum amount of effort and money invested. So when do I go to Facebook? Well, I can tell you that I don't personally have any Facebook stores running. I did test it with a product, but for whatever reason, I couldn't get it working. And I suspect it's because of the product that we were doing, and also suspect because it was the fact that they literally just launched it. I was one of the beta launchers and I couldn't get it to work. But now when I'm thinking about what's called distribution channels, so how do I get my product to market? That's a distribution channel. I look at all the low-hanging fruit. Where can I get the low-hanging fruit, the easiest money? Where's the easiest money to make? And then from there, I ascend through more complex strategies to make the remainder of the money. And oftentimes, these are all going to be based on the 80-20 principle. You know, you'll get 80% of your sales from 20% of your efforts. Well, I'll just want to focus on that 20%. And usually that's Amazon, eBay, Jet, Walmart, things like that. And then a little bit further down the track, perhaps your own website, if that's part and parcel of your overall strategy. But for me, Reg, a Facebook e-commerce store, I don't know many people that start their e-commerce searches on Facebook, and that's what I'm interested in finding. Where are my customers? And I put, and all I do is I've got all the customers, and I put my product in front of all those customers ready to buy, and that's what I seek to do. Hey, Neil here. Just before you go away, that was a question that I got asked on my regular Monday night Q&A session, which I have with the members of the Aussie Online Entrepreneurs. So if you're interested in joining us as an Aussie Online Entrepreneurs, then you can click on the link below to find out a lot more about that. And also, as a special thank you for watching this video, I've got a great book that I want to give you for free. It's a current bestseller on Amazon, and it teaches you everything that you would need to know about starting a business here in Australia on Amazon. So you can see that just up there. So if you'd like to get a copy of that for free, then again, just click on the link below and you'll get a copy of that. You'll get taken to a page where you can get a copy of that for absolutely free. Hope you enjoyed that little snippet from one of my Aussie Online Entrepreneur Q&A sessions, and make sure that you subscribe to my channel and also like this video. And if you've got a question that you would like answering, then post it in the comments below, and I'll do my best to answer it, whether on one of these videos for you or directly in the comments directly below. All right, thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time on the next of the Aussie Online Entrepreneurs Amazon FBA Australia videos. Switch soon.